Jagdeo calls out AP and UAFC government on its racist political campaign through the state media. PPP's presidential candidate receives vote of confidence from Essequibians. Another child dies on the mysterious circumstances at the Georgetown Public Hospital. And in sport, England bowled out for fourth lowest test total against the West Indies. These and more right now on this, our Thursday, January 24, 2019 edition of News Update. Good evening, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thanks for joining us. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo has unmasked the racially charged political campaign being run by the government with the use of the state-run media houses. Here are the details. During a news conference today, opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo lambasted the government for using the state media to promote its racist political campaign. He was at the time referring to the ethnic argument used against the People's Progressive Party by the state media. For this reason, he asked for the Ethnic Relations Commission to look into the matter.
His sole concern is that PPP can't win because look at the ethnic makeup of Ghana. And this is flawed too, because the census in itself was flawed. But this is the typical approach you will see, making only an argument about race, people's race, and arguing PPP can't win.
Chairwoman of the People's National Congress, Valda Lawrence, was bashed for lacing her speech with racial remarks to party supporters. The Ghana Elections Commission, an independent agency, was also called out by its commissioners for hiring persons of a particular ethnicity. The matter is presently before the Ethnic Relations Commission. Essequibians have registered their full support for recently elected People's Progressive Party presidential candidate A. Finale, as he was well received when he arrived on the coast this morning to continue his national outreach. Ali, accompanied by PPP parliamentarian Nigel Darmlal and other party officials, held a number of meetings in the region as well as conducted visits to a number of communities. There he listened to the many concerns of Essequibians, including rice farmers. Among the issues raised are the current state of the rice industry, the lack of job opportunities for Essequibians, including youths, the heavy tax burdens imposed on them by the AP and UAFC government, among other issues. Ali also informed residents of his plans to create opportunities for all Guyanese, his intention to reverse some of the draconian tax measures implemented by the government, create a business-friendly environment, investments in agriculture and cheap energy. He said that a more elaborate plan of his vision for Guyana will be contained in his party's manifesto. Ali is expected to continue his outreach to other parts of the country in coming days and weeks leading up to the general and regional elections, constitutionally due by March 21. You're watching MTV's News Update. More news after the break. Stay with us.
The colors of you.
Available at Infinity Color Shop, Princess and High Street, Georgetown. Telephone 226-7693.
Are you invited to that important event but don't know what to wear or frustrated you're wearing the same dress as everyone else? You crave for this exclusive look? Then do just that with dresses from Exclusive Dresses to Impress. Visit Exclusive Dresses to Impress at Giveland Mall. Contact number 6570166.
Gafoor's proudly presents The Perfect Block, made by the most technologically advanced concrete block making machine in sizes 4 and 6 inches. Perfect because it's the right ratio of cement and sand, with sifting added for greater strength. It's stress tested independently by the UG Civil Engineering Department, and it's cured for longer life. It's now available at a lower price with a 12.5% discount. The Perfect Block from Gafoor's, setting a new benchmark.
Everything is connected. Our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 622-6943.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague. Ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet, presenting Coliomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coliomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coliomac. Only at SlimJet, City Mall, second floor.
Top Printing and Signs, for quality and affordable printing and signs. For your business, flyers, copies, business cards, brochures, posters, banners, A-frame signs, roll-up banners. Top Printing and Signs, company stationeries and supplies. Top Printing and Signs, vehicle graphics, storefront signs, 3D and vinyl cut letters, and much more. Top Printing and Signs, custom design and printing of wedding invitations and funeral programs. Top Printing and Signs, professional and efficient with great customer service and quick turnaround time. Top Printing and Signs, 234 South Road, Lacey Town, Georgetown, Guyana. Call us today at 223-4555 or 695-2199. Top Printing and Signs.
Excellent Creole dishes. Fresh bread and pastries. Yes. Breakfast and lunch available fresh Mondays through Fridays. We open 7 a.m. Delivery available. Wholesale breads and pastries available soon. Call 219-5003. With three locations, Lot 5 Tennis Street, Sophia, 36 Durban Street, GPO Building. Dion's Delight Catering Service. We cater for all occasions.
Save big with everyday low prices at Highway 401 Furniture Store. Choose from our huge inventory of elegant home furnishing, or let's build you a custom piece to suit any room in your home. Elegant dining room sets to sophisticated living room designs. Accessorize your kitchen with modern pieces from our collection. Transform your bedroom with standard to king size beds and mattresses, bedside sets, and vanities. Shop now. Save big at Highway 401 Furniture Store. Making your home a beautiful place. Financing and layaway plans available.
Welcome back. You're still with News Update. The People's Progressive Party, once returned to power in this year's general elections, will make reopen the several sugar estates closed by the APNU AFC and will make every effort to ensure they remain viable. Opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo today made it categorical that once re-elected, the People's Progressive Party will reopen the sugar estates. Three sugar estates were shut on the behest of the government in 2017, plunging thousands of families into poverty. The APNU AFC government, in the absence of any credible study, claimed that the industry was a burden to the country. But Jagdeo said with a proper plan, the industry can be sustained.
You would have to do this subsidies for a while. We did this, and that's why we're saying in Linden, instead of an industry, we gave people a water subsidy that costs electricity subsidy that costs nearly $2 billion a year. It's better, I believe, to put it in an industry where they're working. So that sort of thing. And that brings more benefits to the country, the benefits that I just spoke about. So if you have to help people through a difficult period, help them by making sure they have a job. the bottom line will not be profitable immediately, but at least you're getting these multifunctional benefits from sugar.
He says the revitalization of the sugar industry will keep the country buoyant and functioning.
And it's affordable, because if you can spend $1 billion more on the rental and $1.6 billion more on dietary in government, and over $1 billion more on domestic travel, that alone could have kept the 7,000 plus the other 7,000 jobs or so, 14,000 jobs that you have lost because of the closure of sugar, at least 14,000. You could have kept those jobs going.
PricewaterhouseCoopers has already submitted its report on evaluation of assets for the three estates at Agana Sugar Corporation. But once the People's Progressive Party wins the upcoming elections, it seems the plan of selling off the industry's assets will be shelved. Government's High Court challenged the validity of Charandas Prasad's vote on a December 21, 2018 no confidence motion based on his dual citizenship is barred in law. Attorney representing Prasad, Sanjeev Datadin, said that the government was required to challenge the former parliamentarian's eligibility into an election petition, and that should have been done 28 days after the 2015 general elections. Oral submissions were this morning heard before Chief Justice Roxanne George Wilshire in case two of the confidence motion. The matter was brought by Senior Counsel James Boston through the Attorney General Chambers. He contended that Charandas Prasad, now an ex-parliamentarian who voted in favour of the confidence motion, must be disqualified. Senior Counsel Boston argued that the vote must be deemed invalid as the member, a dual citizen, voted against his party's list.
Charandas' name was extracted from the APNU AFC list, so he cannot vote against the list from which his name was extracted. There was no such thing as conscience vote. You got to vote for the list from which your name was extracted. So when he voted the night in favor of the list from which his name was extracted, our contention is pursuant to Article 156(3). Notionally, his seat, he no longer is a elected member of the National Assembly. Subsequently, you can't take his vote into consideration. Notionally, his vote went, his seat went, and it would have been 32-32.
Attorney representing Charandas Prasad, Sanjeev Datadin, reasoned that the courts does not have the jurisdiction to hear the matter except on the grounds of unconstitutional conduct. He said it is required for the government to file a petition within 28 days after the official would have been elected. Instead, the government filed a fixed date application 3 years, 8 months after discovering the candidate was a dual citizen.
The arguments advanced this morning about being a dual citizen, you need to have brought a petition within 28 days of Mr. Charandas going to Parliament. The argument that he has crossed the floor would mean that the vote would still come, because Article 165(2) is very clear, the provision of what it is and what they're going to do. So there is no basis in the claim that has been brought.
The final ruling on the matter is set for January 31. Two men have so far been arrested in relation to the gunning down of 38-year-old taxi driver Kelvin Walters on the East Bank Demerara Public Road as he was heading home with his wife and daughter. Police say one of the men was arrested at the Woodlands Hospital, where he turned up with severe injuries to one of his legs after Walters rammed two men off their motorcycle. One of the suspects has been identified as 25-year-old Devon Williams of Alboystong, Georgetown. The police said the two suspects, one of whom was already positively identified, have been arrested and are on the guards at a private medical institution. Both suffered injuries consistent with that of a motor vehicle accident. Walters was a prime witness on the failed grenade attack outside Kaiser News in November 2015. Williams is said to be connected to one of the three men, Leroy Williams, Alfie Garway, and Janelle Garway, charged with that incident. We tell you now that a third child has died at the Georgian Public Hospital after being administered what now seems to be a lethal injection. 6-year-old Shariza Mendonca of Queensland Essequibo Coast died this morning at the intensive care unit of the state-run institution days after two other children died from the same injection.
Following several days in the intensive care unit at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation on life support, 6-year-old Shiriza Mendonza, who had been administered a certain medication at the institution, has died. Mendonza, who was diagnosed with leukemia along with two other children, was taken to the pediatric ward of the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation on January 3. It was there that she was injected with the drug before she was slated to undergo chemotherapy. According to initial reports, several days later, Mendonza on December 8 was observed by relatives with a high fever and bumps on her neck. The child had also complained of severe pains throughout parts of her entire body after being injected with the drug. It was then that doctors rushed her to the intensive care unit, where she remained on life support until her demise earlier today. Just a few days ago, the young child's relatives had voiced their frustration regarding the hospital not being forthcoming with information. The Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation, prior to Mendonza's death, but following the deaths of 3-year-old Roshni Sigobin and a 7-year-old Kerwin Edwards, launched an investigation into the circumstances surrounding their deaths and the medication used. In addition to that, the hospital recalled the lethal drug. The hospital noted that those involved in administering the drug, doctors and nurses, will all be questioned internally. However, these health personnel remain on the job. Until its findings, the hospital requests that the families of the children and members of the general public desist speculating on the matter. Meanwhile, efforts to gain further information regarding the name of the drug, which was said to have been administered to the children, have proved futile. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lushona Gomes Cornelius.
You're watching MTV's News Update. More news after the break. Stay with us.
For all your supermarket needs, check out Nirvas at 49 Sheriff and Craig Street, Georgetown. We have a wide variety of groceries, confectioneries, alcohol and non-alcohol beverages. Fresh meat, fruits and vegetables also available. Don't forget to check out our cosmetics section. Best prices, great deals.
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Check out NNY Apparels and Boutique for all your beautiful shalwars, gararas, saris, lehengas, kurtas, and children outfits. Bridal outfits for men and women. We also have in stock Indian jewelry and footwear. Puja items, wedding items, malas, murtis, jandi flags, and much more. So come down to NNY Apparels and Boutique, located at Lot A, Belmont, Mahaika, in the Market Square, bottom floor of the mall, or contact us on telephone number 676-3710. Visit us now for all your Indian items at reasonable prices.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex Toilet Tissue. Super soft and super durable. Guaranteed.
By only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Secure your property, secure your life, get the best security service from us at KGM Security Services Incorporated. Highly trained armed and unarmed officers at affordable rates. We offer armed mobile patrols, personal security, cash escort, alarm monitoring, quick response units. Also, rental of executive vehicles with armed guards. 74 Axora Avenue, Bellier Park, Georgetown. Contact us on 663-3227, 699-0084 or 654-1800. KGM Security Services Incorporated. We are your source for security.
Your one-stop decor solution for gala dinners, weddings, birthdays, cocktail functions, backdrops, props, and more. Check out Exclusive Decor Design, Ground Floor, City Mall. We have a wide variety to suit your stylish seating and table decor, exclusive centerpieces, colorful maro, and much more. Working with a small budget? No problem. We've got you covered. Call 225-4434 or 657-0166. We listen, we create, you enjoy.
Drivers who want to get the most out of their cars. It's Bridgestone or nothing.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's News Update. Ranks of the Ghana Defense Force were early on Thursday encouraged by President David Granger to always be in readiness to defend the country's national sovereignty. The president made this proclamation during the opening of the annual officers' conference at State House.
Held under the theme Effective Transformation for Total National Defense, the annual officers' conference saw the head of state stressing the need for there to be continual training of ranks and for there to be alertness as the country faces a territorial dispute with neighboring Venezuela.
Officers, Venezuela's most recent aggression constituted the second naval assault against our territorial integrity and sovereignty. Venezuelan Navy corvette, the Carina PC-14, made a hostile incursion into Guyana's exclusive economic zone. The incursion took place at approximately 144 kilometers from the boundary that separates Venezuela from Guyana. A helicopter on the platform of the naval corvette attempted to land on the Ramfortets, an unarmed vessel undertaking seismic surveys lawfully within Guyana's EEZ.
Further, President Granger stressed that Guyana remains committed to ensuring that the country and the rest of Latin America and the Caribbean remain a zone of peace, where issues like illegal mining, illegal logging, illegal arms, narcotics, wildlife trafficking, and the smuggling of precious minerals can all be addressed. The president spoke of the need to protect communities located on Guyana's borders.
Communities, particularly those living in our frontier villages, must be made safe from transnational crime. The persistence of transnational crime alerts us to the need for continued vigilance to protect our airspace, land borders, coastline, and territorial sea.
According to the President, with the deployment and presence of GDF ranks at strategic locations along Guyana's border with Venezuela since 2018, issues relating to Guyanese being assaulted by Sindicato gang members have decreased significantly.
Opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo has declared that as his party, he endorsed a statement issued by the government of Guyana as it pertains to the social unrest ongoing in Venezuela. Jagdeo said he was briefed today by Foreign Affairs Minister Carl Greenidge and was sent a statement that was issued by the government on the developments taking place in the country. The government in its statement said that it is gravely concerned at the deepening of the political crisis in Venezuela and supports calls made at both the regional and international levels for immediate dialogue among all stakeholders with a view to the preservation of the democratic process and a return to normalcy. Moreover, the statement continued that Guyana calls on all parties to desist from actions that might lead to further violence and loss of lives. Jagdeo said that he assured Greenidge that his party endorses the statement and will look to a coordinated approach on this matter. A deep depression marked by hyperinflation and shortages of food and medicine has triggered an exodus of Venezuelans to surrounding countries. Chief of Staff of the Guyana Defense Force, Brigadier Patrick West, says in addition to 73% of ranks having successfully gone through training in 2018, the force was also able to place much focus on the safety and accommodation of its soldiers.
According to the 10th Chief of Staff of the Guyana Defense Force, Brigadier Patrick West, 2019 will mark 54 years since the GDF has been given a task to serve as the nation's main source of national security. West indicated that the Guyana Defense Force in 2018 had witnessed an increase in its operational posture, inclusive of active and integrated patrolling. The Chief of Staff explained that such operational position will grow further in 2019.
The patrolling plan for 2019 will see an increase in the number of patrols as well as areas to be covered so that we can dominate more of our land and sea spaces. For 2018, the force was able to ensure that 73% of its ranks underwent local training.
West indicated that it is imperative that further investment in training and development of the force's human resources done in 2019. Through the collaboration with the University of Guyana, West indicated that come June, the two-year redesigned Standard Officers Cadet course at the University of Guyana will see its first batch of graduates graduating with an associate degree. At the same time, the first batch of reserved officers will graduate after an hiatus of 9 years. West acknowledged the increase of the Guyana Defense Force fleet with the addition of more aircrafts and further investments in training of pilots and engineers.
2019 is set to be a better year for our Air Corps. I must say thanks to the Defense Board for its support to the recapitalization of Air Corps. Our Coast Guard continues to play a greater role in patrolling our waterways and in the involvement of with other law enforcement agencies to protect our aquatic resources and contribute in the fight against the narcotics trade and piracy.
The Chief of Staff also reiterated with the presence and anticipated extraction of oil, both the Guyana Defense Force and the Coast Guard must be better able to handle and ensure a safe environment for operational and recovery effort.
Leader of the opposition, Dr. Barrett Jagdeo, says the Alliance for Change is likely to accede to the demand of the PNC to make Cameron Ramjaitan the prime ministerial candidate for the coalition for the upcoming general elections. Jagdeo made a disclosure at his weekly press briefing today, stating that the selection was reportedly made based on requests from the People's National Congress Reform. According to the PPP General Secretary, the AFC will once again conform to its yes-man status and give the PNC what they want. Ramjaitan, at a press conference yesterday, said that the matter is expected to come up this weekend at the party's National Executive Committee meeting. In accordance with the 2015 deal in the form of a Cummingsburg Accord between the two parties, AFC will have the prime ministerial position while the presidential post goes to the Partnership for National Unity. On Monday, President Granger was endorsed by his party, the PNCR, to run for a second term. In fact, the PNCR, the larger partner in the five-partner APNU, officially threw its support behind its leader via a letter from General Secretary Amna Ali. We now join Celine Griffith with your court roundup.
Police officer was today remanded to prison for the rape of a 13-year-old girl after he appeared before Magistrate Sherdell Isaacs Marcus. Assistant Superintendent of Police 31-year-old Sitaran Singh was not required to plead to the indictable offence, which alleged that between the 17th and 18th of June 2018, at an East Bank location, he engaged in sexual activity with a child under the age of 16. He was remanded to prison until February 5. Meanwhile, a woman was today hauled before Magistrate Faith Magasi to answer for fraud. 31-year-old Unique Angelica Hope of Lot 124 Thomas Street, Kitty, denied the charge which alleged on January 17 at Central Immigration and Passport Office, for the purpose of procuring a new passport, made a false statement by signing a written declaration stating that she was Coretta Hope, knowing same to be false. According to reports, the defendant was given her first passport and traveled to Barbados, where she was charged for overstaying and was deported. When she returned to Guyana, she acquired a second passport under the name Onika Ann Benjamin, which she used to travel to Barbados. Once again, she overstayed and was deported. She then went to the Central Immigration and Passport Office with her mother for another passport under the name Coretta Hope, who is her disabled sister. Her mother falsely declared to immigration that she was indeed Coretta Hope. When checks were made, it was discovered that the woman and her mother were lying and arrest warrants were issued. The prosecution stated that other charges are likely to be brought against the woman and the police are currently looking for her mother. Police prosecutor Annalisa Brommel objected to bail based on the seriousness of the offence, as well as the penalty attached to the charge. Hope was granted bail in the sum of $100,000. However, she must produce all passport issued to her before she can be released from custody. She is scheduled to reappear in court on February 6. The man who was charged 2 weeks ago for a series of armed robberies was today slapped with two more charges as he reappeared in court. 23-year-old Sion Goodluck of 3027 Northam Veld pleaded not guilty to the charge which read that on January 8 at Stevedore Housing Scheme, while in the company of another and armed with a gun, he robbed Jason Burberry of a Honda XR motorcycle CJ4339 valued $435,000. A second charge alleged on January 9 at Westrum Veld, he fraudulently imitated an ID number CJ7296 on a Honda XR motorcycle which is registered with CJ4339. He denied the charge. Reports indicate that on the day in question, the defendant contacted the Pizza Hut delivery service and made an order. When the virtual complainant went to drop off the order, he was robbed at gunpoint of his motorcycle and the defendant made good his escape. Goodluck was subsequently arrested and charged for another matter of armed robbery, and the bike was allegedly in his possession at the time. When the victim saw Goodluck's photo in the newspaper, he went to the East Lepinitans police station and made a report. The two charges were instituted today as Goodluck reappeared in court. He was further remanded until February 20. In another matter, a Colombian national was today placed before the court for illegally entering the country. 32-year-old Jose Valencia pleaded guilty to the charge which read that on October 22, 2018 at Central Letem Rupununi, he crossed land frontiers of Guyana and did not present himself to the nearest immigration office. Reports indicate that ranks from the Rose Hall police station came into contact with the man who claimed his passport had been stolen. He was placed into custody and after investigations were complete, was charged for the offence. When given a chance to speak, the man through a translator claimed he entered the country via a bicycle and arrived at 11 in the night. He further stated that the immigration office was closed and no security was present. According to the man, he then walked to Georgetown. Valencia was ordered to undergo a psychiatric evaluation by the magistrate since he failed to make much sense in court. He was remanded to prison until February 12 to facilitate same, after which he will be sentenced. Finally, a handyman was today remanded after he appeared before Magistrate Faith Magasi to answer to a simple larceny charge. Mark Patterson, 60, of Lot 89 Pike Street, Kitty, pleaded not guilty to the charge against him, which stated that on January 21 at Bel Air Park, Georgetown, he stole a quantity of tools valued $160,000 property of Marlon Baksh. Police prosecutor Sion Blackman objected to bail, citing the value of the articles as well as the fact that the articles were found in the defendant's bag. Patterson was remanded until February 13. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
Rajesh Lakhan now joins us with today's edition of What Do People Say.
How prepared are you to cast your vote after the passage of a no-confidence motion on December 21, which paved the way for fresh elections within 90 days? Let's hear what the people had to say.
Well, I must say I was surprised, but however, we just need to do our best to be prepared because as a citizen, it's our democratic right to vote, and we all need to participate in order for our voices to be heard.
And you're prepared to cast your vote?
I am.
Well, when the time comes, I'll see. Can't say anything right now.
So you're prepared to head to the polls?
Yeah.
No, I'm not ready yet for a head out to the poll because, you know, if you go to the poll right now, you're not going to get all people to come and vote right now because everybody's put their mind for next year election.
Well, definitely if it has anything to do with elections, with electing a responsible person to run my country, I'm very much prepared at always. I'm always willing to go out and vote, right, for the party that I think that would do a good job. So with the passing of that no confidence motion, I'm very prepared. Whenever there's rallies or anything, I would try my best to pay attention to what's going on. So definitely I would go out and vote. And especially the results of that no confidence motion, I'm very, very eager to go out and vote because of that.
Well, whenever it arrives, we have to do it, right? Because that is what it stated. But we got to wait and hear the decision.
Given that is what is stated in the Constitution, you think the government should resign and call early election?
It's in a resign mode at the moment, is it? Because remember, once you prepare for elections, you can't go into very deep arrangements as a government. And this is why it's it.
I'm pretty prepared because, you know, it's, the government is at, well, not the government, the country's at a standstill. There's no production, you're not seeing no production and so forth. So get it over with. Let everybody come together, make a decision, and make this place great again.
I'm very ready. I'm one that follows politics a lot because of my mother. So I was watching it for the longest while. So I was monitoring the situation. So I knew that I would have had to prepare myself to go to the polls. So if they say elections is tomorrow, I'd be ready.
For MTV News Update, I'm Rajesh Lakhan.
Here is Kipani Jordan with your tips for healthy living.
A joint strain is overstretching or tearing of muscles or tendons. Tendons are the dense, fibrous cords of tissue that connect bones to muscles. The most common locations for muscle strain are the hamstring muscle and the lower back. The symptoms of a sprain and a strain are very similar. That's because the injuries themselves are very similar. Our bodies work hard day after day, so an occasional strain or sprain isn't uncommon. Certain situations make you more likely to injure your joints. These include athletic activities or exercise, including running or jogging, accidents such as falling or slipping, lifting heavy objects, overexerting yourself, sitting or standing in an awkward position, and/or prolonged repetitive motion. To diagnose, doctors often diagnose a sprain or strain by excluding other causes of your symptoms. After a brief physical exam, your doctor may request an x-ray. An x-ray will rule out any breaks or fractures. If the x-ray isn't conclusive, your doctor might request another type of imaging test called an MRI. An MRI can give your doctor a very detailed view of the joint. An MRI might reveal very small or thin breaks that an X-ray can't identify. If neither the MRI nor X-ray reveals any breaks or injuries to the bone, your doctor will likely diagnose a sprain or strain.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sports update and more. Stay with us.
When you need money and you gotta get it fast, Creative Jewelry and Pawn Shop is the place for that confidential transaction in a quiet and secure location. You'll get the highest value per penny weight for your gold and also enjoy the lowest interest rates and longest payback period too. Yes, for that instant transaction to solve a pressing financial problem. Let Creative Jewelry and Pawn Shop, 4-6 Boyle Place, that's between the Ministry of Housing on Brick Dam and White Castle Fish Shop, be your first and only choice. Creative Jewelry and Pawn Shop, safe and sound, solid and secure, always there for you. Telephone 231-7878 and 223-8955.
Secure your property, secure your life, get the best security service from us at KGM Security Services Incorporated. Highly trained armed and unarmed officers at affordable rates. We offer armed mobile patrols, personal security, cash escort, alarm monitoring, quick response units, also rental of executive vehicles with armed guards. 74 Axora Avenue, Bellaire Park, Georgetown. Contact us on 663-3227, 699-0084 or 654-1800. KGM Security Services Incorporated. We are your source for security.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
Computer High Tech at the height of technology. 42 Gold Street, Stavro. Telephone 223-7866.
Champion Whole Wheat Chow Mein. It's 100% whole wheat. That's why it's my number one choice.
As a mom, you want your kids to eat healthy.
At any age, eating healthy is not an option. It's a must.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
For the best in truck spares, Daff and Cummings, it's A1 Auto Value New Road Freedom Hoop on the west side. Check them out today for seals, alternators, filters, air valves, pistons and rings, air dryers, shocks, bearings, and a whole lot more. Parts and accessories for cars and minibuses. Call today on 254-0890. 64 New Road Freedom Hoop on the west coast of Demerara. A1 Auto Value. Performance without compromise.
We'll be right back.
With thousands of items to choose from at everyday low prices, it's a guarantee that you'll save big at Raymond Hanif's General Store. From local products to the best foreign brands, you'll find everything you need and so much more. When we say more, we mean more. More products for more savings. Expect more, pay less. Raymond Hanif's General Store, 48 Princess Street, Georgetown, Guyana.
Did you know that Hand in Hand is the longest established property insurer in Guyana? We've been serving Guyanese for over 151 years. You can visit our 15 offices countrywide, whether you're in Berbice, East Coast, East Bank, Linden, West Coast, Essequibo, or in Georgetown. You will enjoy competitive rates and a superior customer service, as well as our convenient payment options through MMG and Scotia Online. Hand in Hand, safeguarding your family, always secure.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall. ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome to MTV's Sports Update. England were dismissed for just 77 in their first innings of the first test against the West Indies at the Kensington Oval in Bridgetown, Barbados today. This was England's fourth lowest completed innings total in a test against the West Indies, with fast bowler Kemar Roach taking 5 wickets for 17 runs in 11 overs. It was the sixth time this century England had been dismissed for under 100 in a test innings. They made 79 against Australia in 2002, 81 against Sri Lanka in 2007, 51 in Kingston in 2009, 72 against Pakistan in 2012, and 58 against New Zealand last year. Thursday's collapse was also the lowest completed innings total in a test at the Kensington Oval, breaking the record of 81 shared by India in 1997 and Pakistan in 2017. The one major consolation for Joe Root's tourists was that they avoided posting a New England's low against the West Indies. In 1994, needing 194 to win the third test in Port of Spain, Trinidad, England slumped to 46, all out as outstanding fast bowler Courtney Ambrose took 6 for 24 in 10 overs. They were also bundled out for 51 in an innings and 123-run defeat in the first test at Kingston, Jamaica in 2009, with Jerome Taylor taking 5 for 11 and spinner Solomon Benn 4 for 31. England's lowest completed 4 innings total in a test against the West Indies was their 71 all-out at Old Trafford back in 1976. Fast bowling great Michael Holding, like Roach today, took 5 for 17 but in 14.5 overs. West Indies eventually won that match in Manchester by 425 runs after opener Gordon Greenidge scored hundreds in each of their innings. As part of the Cricket West Indies continued support to bring international cricket back home to Pakistan, the West Indies women's team has agreed to play their 2-20 matches in Karachi prior to the 3-match ICC Women's Championship ODI matches in the United Arab Emirates.
The 3 T20Is will be played on January 31 and February 1 and 3 at the Southend Club before the two sides go head-to-head in 3 ODIs in Dubai on February 7, 9 and 11. The first ODI will be played at the Dubai International Cricket Stadium, while the second and the third ODIs will be played at the ICC Academy. As part of their series preparation, the Windies women will arrive in Dubai on Saturday for a training and acclimatization camp before traveling to Karachi on January 30. Following a very detailed security plan from the Pakistan Cricket Board and the independent security assessment from Eastern Star International, Stephanie Taylor has opted out of touring Pakistan and will join the team for the ICC Women's Championship ODIs in Dubai. Marissa Aguilera will take over as captain for the T20Is in Pakistan, with Shakira Salman as vice-captain. Stephanie Taylor will resume as captain for the ODIs in Dubai. The Windies women are currently ranked 4th in the ICC Women's T20I rankings, while Pakistan are ranked 7th. However, in the ODI rankings, the West Indies are 6th, with the Pakistanis 7th. After 3 rounds of the ICC Women's Championship, the West Indies are sitting in 4th position on 9 points with 4 wins and is 6th on 8 points with 4 wins and 5 losses. The full Windies women's squad for Pakistan Tour 2019 includes Stephanie Taylor, Marissa Aguilera, Shamaine Campbell, Shamila Connell, Deandra Dottin, Afi Fletcher, Chanel Henry, Kaisia Knight, Natasha McLean, Anissa Mohammed, Chadine Nation, Karishma Ramharak, Shakira Salman and Rashada Williams. Karishma Ramharak replaces Hayley Matthews, who suffered a medial knee ligament damage to her right knee in early December. Hayley still requires another 3 to 4 weeks of therapy before she can resume playing. Chelsea Griffith reporting for MTV Sports Update.
The Ghana Boxing Association, in collaboration with Alfred MacDonald, will be hosting the second edition of the Patrick Ford Memorial Tournament on February 17 at the National Gymnasium.
This will be the GBA's first international event of the year, kicking off their calendar of activities, and will have almost 15 fights. President of the GBA, Steve Ninval, confirmed that the list of Trinidad's contingent was received. St. Lucia and Suriname have since confirmed their participation and will be sending their lists by tomorrow. The rankings of Guyana's top 6 elite boxers are Kevin Alicock, Desmond Amsterdam, Colin Lewis, Jamal Eastman, Mark Kimber-Pierre and Sean Griffith, ahead of Pan Am Games scheduled for April. The first fist will be thrown in the ring at the National Gymnasium on Mandela Avenue at 19 hours. Chelsea Griffith reporting for MTV Sports Update.
The search for missing footballer Emiliano Salas and pilot David Boston has been called off after rescuers failed to find their plane. Cardiff City's Argentine striker 28 in Boston from Crawley, Lincolnshire, won the aircraft that disappeared from radar on Monday. After 3 days of scouring the English Channel, authorities made a decision to abandon the search. But Salas's sister Romina pleaded with rescuers to keep looking for him. Harbour Master Captain David Barker said chances of survival were extremely remote. We reviewed all the information available to us, as well as knowing what emergency equipment was on board, and have taken the difficult decision to end the search, he added. He understands Salas's family is not content with the decision to stop the search, but is absolutely confident that they could not have done any more. Captain Barker said the depth of the sea where the plane had last contact was about 100 metres, and it will remain a missing persons case for the police. He had returned to the French city to say a final farewell to his former teammates before taking the plane back to the Welsh capital. More news after the break. Stay with us.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back. You're still with News Update. Now for some news in the region. Russia has condemned foreign powers for backing a Venezuelan opposition leader who declared himself interim president, calling it a bid to usurp power. Moscow said that the move violated international law and was a direct path to bloodshed. Juan Joshua declared himself interim leader Wednesday, a move recognized by the U.S. and several other nations. President Nicolas Maduro, who retains some other nations' support, broke off relations with the U.S. in response. Mr. Maduro has been in office since 2013. He was sworn in for a second term earlier this month after winning a May 2018 election marred by an opposition boycott and widespread claims of vote rigging. On the international scene, former Scottish First Minister Alex Salmond has appeared in court charged with attempted rape and sexual assault. He faced a total of 14 charges at Edinburgh Sheriff Court, also including breach of peace and indecent assault. The 64-year-old made no plea during the hearing and was released on bail. Outside court, Mr. Salmond said he was innocent of any criminality and added that he would defend himself to the utmost. Police had been investigating following a Scottish government inquiry into complaints of sexual harassment against Mr. Salmond. Mr. Salmond, who was First Minister from 2017 to 2014, was interviewed by police on Wednesday. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 8:09. Let's turn our attention to the Demer Harbour Bridge and the Barbies River Bridge schedules. And that's a wrap on today's broadcast. Before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Jagdeo calls out APNU-AFC government on its racist political campaign through the state media. PPP's presidential candidate receives vote of confidence from Essequibians. Another child dies under mysterious circumstances at the Church of Public Hospital. And in sport, England bowled out for fourth lowest test total against the West Indies. Qatari broadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thanking you for watching. Have a good night.